Hi everyone. I've received a few emails just about getting a little refresher on where you can access an APA referencing guide. This is something that I've provided to our DP1 students already, and you're welcome to use this in your own subject areas for IAs and things like that. So we're accessing this through the AUT Library, and this is basically, I think it's a very foolproof guide to the APA referencing style. It's currently we're currently using APA the 7th edition, but it's very new, so we can definitely accept the 6th edition at this point in time. If you just basically use the tabs on the left-hand side here, it will just guide you through firstly what an in-text citation should look like when done in APA referencing style. So it gives you a list basically of how an in-text citation should look if there's no author, if there's one author, two authors, six or more authors, etc. And that's something that's really important that we're checking with our students when we are marking their submissions. The other thing that it also gives you is how to reference according to different text types. So, for example, how should a reference look as a bibliography reference, or how should it look as an in-text citation if it's a book, if it's an ebook? If it's a website, so on the left-hand side here, the kids can basically just click whatever text type they're using, whether it's a video, and it's just a good way for you to double check that they're referencing in the right manner. So I've linked this website into your email, and I think once you jump on, it's quite self-explanatory as to how to use it and how to make sure that your kids are referencing properly. The other thing that I'll just quickly guide you towards is something that I've also provided for our students, which is CiteFast. Don't be turned off by the really quality banner at the top of the screen there. It's actually a very good tool. So it's quite easy. You can see it's using APA 6 or 7. So the kids will obviously just select which style of APA they're using. I've been telling them to go with 7 or 6. They're quite similar, really. And basically, they can just input their information. So I'm just going to make up the year that it was published, and a random title, and a random publisher. And as you can see at the bottom of my screen, it's literally just generated that citation for me. So if you have a student who is making some severe errors in their referencing, just guide them back towards CiteFast. Sometimes they just forget that they've already been shown this sort of stuff, and they just need a reminder to be guided in the right direction. It will literally save a whole list of references for them, and it will download for them as a bibliography. So makes their life easier, and there's really no excuse for poor referencing in this day and age with all of the technology and all of the resources that we have. So I've linked both of these sites into that email for you, and hopefully this will help some of you who just wanted a refresher on APA.